I'm Nick Papadakis, and these are my creations. I feel like I'm more an investigator, an adventurer, an explorer. I'm curious. Every day in the studio, I have to make something. And if I only have a few minutes, it's a collage. If I have all day, it's a painting study. I've always just been committed to following a tangent and to making whatever piece seems most relevant to me at the moment, and to make it solely for the reason that it occurred to me and I had the impulse to follow through on it. I think up a lot of ideas and I let them simmer. And if they don't resonate 6 months later, they're not worth pursuing. There are other pieces that I let simmer for a year and I come back to them and I realize, you know what? It's a recurrent motif. It's a recurrent thought. It's something that's perennial. It needs to be turned into a painting. I mean, it goes on and on and on. Dead flies from my windowsill. I don't know why, but a couple of variations. These are some really old collage mixed media pieces. These are like my little surrealist rooms that I used to make when I was a kid. I was definitely of a post-industrial, slightly depressed, anti-consumerist, disbelieve the news media kind of mentality as a teenager. My defining of myself was not to be that, and not to be that, and I don't want to do what they do, and I don't want to make work that looks like that. It was a removal. It's let me get rid of everything else that I know isn't me. Not with the goal of finding out what was me, but just to make sure that other people's baggage and purpose and mission and beliefs and stuff weren't mine, that I wasn't going to appropriate them without having earned them. This might be my oldest little drawing here. This is probably 13, maybe. So one of what I would consider probably one of my oldest mature pieces. And it's interesting because when I look at a piece like this now, I don't even know how I made it. It's a whole different person. I always joke around about putting on a group show and having it be all my work and see what people say about the insight that the curator had about pulling together all these different artists that had a certain undercurrent. One day I realized, oh, you know what? I need a banquet table. I decided to just make like the cabinet maker's table. All the dovetails, mortise and tenons, breadboarding, like every proper piece of joinery in one piece of furniture. To me, that's what I like to make. One of everything, in a way. That's what I want the arc of my studio life to be. One piece of furniture done perfectly. One piece of blown glass. One bronze sculpture. One perfect transparent oil glaze painting that I can sit down with Vermeer or Maxfield Parrish or Salvador Dali and just be able to like talk shop and not feel out of place. Like that's, you know, that's the goal that I set for myself. For every one of my nieces and nephews that get born, I hand-forged sterling silver rings with their initials carved into the handles. I used to build all sorts of industrial leather bags. That was a sterling silver cake server that I made for a friend's wedding gift. I don't know if you're familiar with the Motor City Bar down on Ludlow Street. It's a Detroit-themed dive bar that friends of mine from Detroit made. But I designed the entire interior of that. This is Where Do We Find It? I don't know if you can see all the way in this polished window there. There's a Burger King Whopper inside of here, encased in resin.
I had been walking around Providence, Rhode Island all day and I was getting really hungry. So I went to a Burger King and I bought a Whopper and I thought, you know, people eat Whoppers all day long and then they poop them out and there's no artifact. 1,000 years from now, nobody's gonna know what a Whopper looked like. So I bought 2 Whoppers instead of 1, and I brought the second one home, and along the way I bought a couple of gallons of casting resin, and I thought, let me preserve a Whopper in clear casting resin. This is just pure powder. I take the pigment, I mix it with chemicals, I float on the panel, I create all whatever the fractal patterning, as they would actually occur in nature as well. So when I get a finished basic panel, it exhibits the same kind of like deposition patterns that you see in river deltas when you're flying from an airplane, or mountain ranges that all fan off with their valleys eroding away. All of those large scale earth patterns happen on my panels in microscopic scale. When it dries, it's just dust again. So I can go back with a paintbrush and start pulling it off. This whole panel had been all dark and dense with this pattern all the way across. And so I knew that there were 3 skeletons buried inside of this pigment. So I went with my paintbrushes, just like an archaeologist goes with their toothbrushes and dental picks. And I started dust, and pull away all of this darkness to reveal these highlights. And bit by bit, as I dust away, it's almost like I'm chiseling a 2-dimensional sculpture. I'm removing material. I'm bringing out the volumes of the figure from all of this rocky matrix. I can't force this pigment process to do something that's against its nature. I have to turn myself off and just observe how the pigment works. When it works, it's just the most amazing thing in the world, because it's something that I could never have achieved otherwise. I think really a great artist has to know their craft inside and out, has to have a dialogue with their craft and push it to a whole different level that nobody has seen before. Each person's story and their path to a successful arts career is different. And so if you ask a Mark Kostabi or a Jeff Koons or a Shepard Fairey, anybody, their story is different from anybody else's. And if they say, oh, you have to come from this kind of family, or if you have to go get a master's or a doctorate from Yale, or you have to paint the same painting at least 250 times to gain traction, you know, whatever they say, it's so ephemeral and intangible and hard to apply to people, that you can't duplicate somebody's path. Tons of people that have never met me before, have never seen the work before, don't know good art from bad art, step in front of one of my paintings and stop. Stop in their tracks and just have a moment. They tell me what the painting is. When somebody has that kind of engagement with a piece that was a total random, spontaneous whim in my studio, that to me says that I've become an artist.